As you can see, I've just been working along here on this project. I've completed the nice large fist that is Bruce's fist. You can see it in smaller form here on the chart, which is, as you can see, become just a little bit tattered and marked up as I've been working with it. So I thought this was a good row to stop and show you what I was up to and the progress. Now that I've worked the last little black stitches in this section, I no longer need that black yarn. That also means that I no longer need the second piece of the chartreuse yarn that was being used to knit this area. So I'm just going to flip over to the back side of my work so you can see what this is looking like. Okay, a little messy, but it's the back, right? But just in case you ever thought you'd be working a reversible intarsia project, not unless you're making two of these and sewing them together. So here you can see this bobbin's almost spent, and I'm just at the point where, let's see. So I actually tied off the black yarn on the previous row, and now I've got these two bobbins. And now that I'm working all chartreuse for the remainder of the fist, I don't need this. So I'm going to take the one with the short. I'm actually just going to take this yarn off the bobbin and tie a knot here. By the way, when I'm doing this, I like to make sure that both the needle is inside the stitch. And then I pull this nice and tight, and that makes sure that those two stitches are going to have good tension on either side. Let's go ahead and tie that knot. And, oops, that's a granny knot. Do that again, right. Square knots are always better in knitting. You really don't want your knot to come out. So, there's the square knot. Okay, so tie that. I'm gonna trim off this, and now I can continue knitting the row, which was a wrong side row, in case you were wondering.